Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Mukhmohit and welcome back to my channel. Today we are going to talk on a very important issue, that is personal protective equipment. A lot of queries had come in, so we are going to have a discussion right now. But before I take up, I would like to thank all our healthcare professionals, ASHA workers, Anganwadi, lab technician, pulmonologists, critical care people who are our frontline doctors. Thank you so much for extending all your help and risking yourself for the sake of managing this pandemic crisis. I would also like to thank all our defense personnel, CRPF, ITBP, BSF people, people who are working in electricity department, in waterworks department, in who are people who are working for LPG cylinder deliveries, people who are working in fire, police personnel, traffic police. Thank you so much for all your help. I would also like to thank all our hospital staff, the housekeeping staff, the people who are involved in biomedical waste, sewage treatment plants. Thank you so much for being there all the time. So let's get on and let's start with the personal protective equipment. So first is, personal protective equipment is required by whom? Personal protective equipment will be required by general public, or you could be a healthcare worker, or you could be involved in aerosol generating work. So I can have three people: general public, doctor who's a healthcare professional involved in COVID patients, care of COVID patients, or a person, doctor or nurse or staff, anybody who's involved in aerosol generating techniques or procedures. For aerosol generating techniques, procedure like tracheal intubation, like CPR, like giving non-invasive ventilation, manual ventilation, intracheostomy, intubation, all these things. So anywhere where there are aerosol generating products or techniques. So let us first take on this phenomena, that in case you are general public, if you are a medical doctor, you need to tell this to all your near dear ones, that in case you are general public who is not having any risk, there is no recommendation to wear mask or glove. In fact, if you tend to wear mask, a lot of bacteria, bacilli, viruses are coming and sticking to the outside surface. So you are inhaling a loading dose. That is dangerous. In case you are wearing gloves, you tend to be more carefree. You touch hair, you touch all the surfaces, which causes, rather than decrease of the chain of transmission, it increases the chances of transmission of virus from one place to another. So you do not want to wear mask or gloves in general public. In case you are a doctor and you are working as a healthcare professional for management of COVID-19 cases, you need to take up the personal protective equipment. What are the constituents of this personal protective equipment? You need to have a gown, which should be a waterproof gown. We should have gloves. I would suggest you to have two pair of gloves, like doubling of the gloves in case it's possible. Use of medical mask and eye protection. Eye protection includes the goggles or the face shield. Of course, common sense, face shield is slightly better than the goggles, but of course it depends on person to person. In case you are involved in an aerosol generating work, like we have already talked about, intubation, ventilation, bronchoscopies and things like this, you need to take a respirator mask. Respirator mask is different from a medical mask. We'll just see it right now. You also need to have eye protection in terms of goggles or whatever, gloves and gowns, doubling of gloves and doubling of gowns with an apron layering. So this is with apron layering, and of course boot covers are required. There are something called as hazmat suits. What are hazmat suits? These are full body protection right from helmet to the boot. They offer a double or a triple layering, and they are used in biological warfare or usually in category A bioterrorism agents, or in persons who are intensivists who are working in aerosol generating areas for longer durations. But anyways, we are not going to talk about the hazmat suits right now. We are talking of the basic personal protective equipment. So please remember, general public, no gloves, no gowns, nothing, no this thing, masks also. For doctors, we do require medical masks, gloves, gowns and all these things. Aerosol generating, you need to have good quality. What are the types of masks? Masks can be of many types. Masks can be reusable mask, or they can be disposable mask. Common sense. Masks can also be insulating type of mask, or they can be filtration type of mask. Common sense. We normally use which type of mask? Common sense. We use the filtration type of mask. Masks can also be medical mask or they can be respirator mask, right? So now let us talk about the medical mask and then we will talk about the respirator mask. The medical mask, they are measured in terms of biological filtration efficiency. They are measured in terms of BFE1, BFE2. You have different types of masks. Biological filtration efficiency 1, efficiency 2. It's usually 90%, 95% and so on. Biological filtration efficiency, these are the standards for the medical mask. The medical mask, they are also, there is another important difference. The medical mask are also tested. The medical mask is also tested from the point of exhalation to outside. So it is tested from exhalation. Where do you exhale from your mouth? So if this is the mask, it is tested from inside of the mask towards the outside. So it is tested from the inside of the mask to the outside. It is called as from the exhalation point to outside. So basically, medical mask will give you some filtration. And more importantly, it will also tend to protect your flora from contaminating the environment. Are you getting it? It is more efficient towards the inner side. So it is efficient outside a little bit and efficient inside as well, more towards inside. And this stops you contaminating the environment and environment contaminating you. And this is what we normally use in the clinics or in the hospital. These are medical masks. We also have respirator masks. Respirator masks are, these are technically made masks. They are not normal, the surgical mask or the medical mask. The respirator masks, these can be these are quantified or these are tested based on full face protection value, FFP. So you can have FFP1, FFP2, or we can have FFP3. FFP1, 2 or 3. FFP1 is a lower level of mask. It gives you protection from occupational hazards and from dust. It has a filtration capacity of 80% and it has leakage. It has a leakage capacity, or not capacity, it has a leakage value, could be up to 22%, could be anything less than 20%. It is used to protect people who are working in hazardous occupation environments or in conditions where there's a lot of dust exposure to save their lungs from pneumoconiosis and other things. The FFP2, it has a filtration capacity of 90 to 95% and a leakage capacity up to or maximum up to 8%. This is what is used and recommended for control of biological hazards. So this is FFP2 is what is recommended for control of biological hazards. FFP3 is still better. It is still higher. It gives you up to 99% filtration and less than 2% leakage. So this is not readily used. It is used in areas which have lot of asbestos exposure, in people who are exposed to asbestos for 5 years, for 10 years and things, and for longer time. So basically FFP1 and FFP3 are for environmental exposure or occupational exposures. If you talk on another point, you can also have respirator masks which are of another categories. We can have the respirator mask which is N category, R category and P category. The N category is no oil resistance, R means it is oil resistant, and P means completely oil resistant. So P offers complete oil resistance. We don't need that, at least for medical concerns. R is also not required. N is what we normally use. N can be of many types. We can have N95, N99 or N100. We can have R95 or P95, P99, P100 and so on. 95 means 95% filtration capacity, 99% and almost 100%. So medically we use N95 or N99. Common sense, I think everybody understands N99 is slightly better, but of course in terms of pandemic controls, in terms of large people who are using N95 masks, it is difficult to provide everyone with an N99 mask. So there are chances of getting exposure as well. So what we use during pandemics or during biological outbreaks is either we use N95 or N99 or a FFP2 level respirator mask. So these are your recommended masks. Let us have a look at some of the masks. So now if we see this mask, let us say this is mask number A, B, C and D. I think it's common sense, which of the following masks out of A, B, C, D, which of the following masks do you see are like reusable masks? Which one do you think is reusable? Common sense, I think everybody can understand. This is a reusable mask. So it has a filter inside and you can just change the filter. Of course, B, C and D, these are all respirator masks. The B is a respirator mask. It is a double layered mask. So you don't need to remember all these double layered or what, but just that the look of it should tell you it's not a medical mask, because it has a valve over here, it has a valve inlets over here. These valves help to breathe fresh air, and these are specifically designed respirator masks, and they are being assessed from inside to outside or outside to inside. These are assessed from outside towards inside. So they go from the point of testing is from inhalation. They are the maximum blockages towards the inhalation point. And then as they come inside, they give you ease of filtration. So the maximum filtration is towards the outer surface. These are the respirator masks, N95 respirator masks. In this section, we are going to talk about the PPE donning and doffing. What is this? This is known as donning. What do you mean by donning? Donning is nothing but awning. Awning means put on, right? So donning, remember, as put on. So donning is awning and you put on the PPE. So what do you do first? As you can see in this picture, this is the Government of India guideline, and this image has been taken from the CDC guidelines. So these are all recommended international guidelines. So first level is you wear the gown. First level is you wear the gown along with the boots in case the person is wearing a boot. Next is the person has to wear a mask. The lower string should be tied first and then the upper string. The lower is tied first and then the upper string, and then you put the mask and you just pinch over here so that this becomes airtight. It is important to pinch near the nose so that you can seal off any of the air, minimize the air which can come in. Next is you proceed further towards taking care of your eyes and face, and last is to wear the gloves. Please remember, this is just one small MCQ, that gloves has to be worn in the last. Gloves have to be worn in the last. The first thing to wear is the gown. Next is, what is this guideline about doffing? What is this guideline about doffing? What is doffing? Common sense, doffing means taking off. Doffing means taking off, that is D-O-F-F-I-N-G, doffing. In doffing, the first thing that we do is take off the gloves. You remove the gloves, that is the first thing. Where do you discard the gloves? They go into the red bag, red category. The other things go into the yellow category. Until and unless they are not hazardous and it's being told that they have to be specifically designed for red category, until and unless it's all to be going into the yellow category. So next is we remove the face mask or the goggles. Second is we remove the gown. And last is, this is the most important. This is important that the gloves, that the mask has to be taken off in the last. Please remember, write it in big capital words that you have to take off the mask only after you exit the room. Remember in big numbers that you have to take off the mask only after you exit. You close the door, you take off your mask. How do you take off your mask? You open the lower string first and then you open the upper string. If you finish the open the lower string and then you take this mask outside. Otherwise, it will just fall on you, right? So please remember, the mask has to be taken out in the last after exiting. There is another type of guideline, that is again the CDC guideline, that you can take off the gloves along with the apron or the gown. Now, in certain cases, especially in cases like COVID-19, the government is giving a tearable gown. So these are tearable gowns which you take off along with the gloves and you discard together. So this goes in the red bin, because these are specifically designed gowns for red bin. Otherwise, if nothing is mentioned in your MCQ, I do not want to generate any controversy. Please remember, gowns go in the yellow bin, gloves go in the red bin. Gowns go in the yellow bin, gloves go in the red bin. No controversy. So in case you are taking them off together, the gloves and the gown will go together and you can take them off together. Simple answer. This is the guideline by international guideline. I'm not making this anything from my own. I'm not making any understanding over here. It is given here pictographically represented and you can just check that. In next is, you take off the face shield, of course. And the last I told you, the last to do is, once you are off with all your covering, then you take off the face mask. And finally, you do hand washing. I think everybody knows about the 8 steps of hand washing. It's a lot of circulated on social media. So of course, sometimes these things do help us, that they help us learn more vividly and more easily. So that's all about wearing the PPEs. So the next is, we are going to spend just 1 minute on this last topic in this module, that we'll talk about the spill management of blood or body fluids. So please remember, I just want to reassure you that there is no new COVID-19 spill management protocol. It's the same spill management protocol. I'm just reinforcing the same. So in case of spill, what is the first thing you're going to do? Nothing about the spill. You just have to wear your gloves and PPE. First is protect yourself. Then you go and near the spill and you just see what it is. And then you place a paper towel, newspaper, blotting paper, absorbing paper, any paper on the spill, and you let it stay there. Once you put that spill, it is going to absorb the thing, and then you discard it. Where will you discard it? Please remember, it has to be discarded in the yellow bin. Now, after you take off all the spill, now you cover the spill with an equal volume of disinfectant. The usual disinfectant that we use is a hypochlorite solution. It is anything which ranges from 1 to 10% hypochlorite solution. From 1% to 10%, anything can be used. Preferably, I think in most of the health centers, we are giving 1% hypochlorite solution that can be used. That is a good disinfectant. This disinfectant, you put equal amount and it stays for 20 minutes over the spill. Now, you take another roll of, after this thing is done, you take another roll of paper towel or absorbing paper. And you clean the area. Once we clean the area, this paper towel again is discarded. Which discarded? It goes into the yellow bin. Please remember, it will go into the yellow bin. Now this area is clean. So after decontamination, now we use detergent or usual floor disinfectant to clear these stains, and there you go. So now you have to mention all this in your spill management register. You have to inform your seniors. That's all. So after that, of course, you remove the gloves and wash hands. So as easy as that. So this is a simple spill management protocol of blood or blood products. There's nothing known as COVID-19 spill management protocol. And with that, I would like to thank all the frontline workers again for their immense effort in managing this COVID-19 pandemic and adhering to all the protocols by ICMR, NIHFW, by Government of India, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. I would really like to thank everyone for their wholehearted support in this. Stay safe, use PPE, and you have the full right to wear a PPE and then go near to a COVID suspect or a COVID confirmed patient. Stay safe yourself. You have to be safe. It is your moral responsibility to stay safe. Thank you so much. All the very best.